Hey everyone, my name's Pupsker, and today we're going over where to farm Mesa and Mesa Prime. Mesa is one of those warframes that has a decent amount of prereqs actually required. If we just go to the navigation map, we can see where Mesa can be farmed, and that's on Eris. And that is at the Mutalist Alid V Assassinate, but as you can see, it's locked out. That is because it does have some pre-requirements, so let's go over those first. The first prerequisite is that Patient Zero, the quest, is completed, and that is so that you can get the next prerequisite. And the next prerequisite is that the Mutalist Alid V Assassinate is created. As you can see, it's a pretty simple recipe other than the Mutalist Alid V nav coordinate. That is kind of a pain to farm, and it's not that hard per se, it'll just take some time. So one of the easier ways to farm it is through infested invasions. At the moment, it doesn't look like there are any infested invasions that drop his nav coordinate. That is unfortunate. About one a day should drop his nav coordinate, so make sure you're checking those somewhat frequently. Another thing that you can do is you can do some derelict farming. So it drops in the Orican Derelict Defense and the Orican Derelict Survival. You'll have to build the keys to run these. Yeah, I know, it's a pain if you want to run them, but hey, it is what it is. On the Orican Derelict Defense, it drops at a 12.5% chance at a B drop rotation, and on the Survival, it drops at a 22.56% chance also on a B drop rotation. You can technically also do Sabotage in the Derelict and like Hive missions, but I wouldn't really recommend it because the drop rate on that is 2 and 5%, so it's not too high there, but if you're grinding for it anyways, hey, why not, right? Once you do farm up all of the required ingredients to start farming the Mutalist Alid V node, it will take some time. Mesa Blueprints drop at 38.72% chance, Neuroptics drop at 38.72% chance, and the Systems Blueprint drops at 22.56% chance. I should have said Neuroptics Blueprint, but whatever. So it's not a crazy spread. There's a decent chance you'll get the system somewhat fast, but it can take some time because you do have to farm up multiple Mutalist Alid V coordinates, and that is indeed a pain in the ass. The fight itself for Mutalist Alid V is fairly simple for anyone who's ever done it. It is quite simply this. Shoot at Mutalist Alid V, but he will be invulnerable. The only way he won't be invulnerable is when he takes off that necklace that he has around him to attack. Then you can actually deal some damage. I would recommend bringing a weapon that can deal very high damage in a low amount of bullets, because he does go invincible, and then once he does, his shield can regenerate a good amount. So bring a hard-hitting weapon for sure. I would recommend doing this solo, because Mutalist Alid V has a gimmick where if you're in a group, he can take control of one person at a time, and then if that person has a really strong weapon, they can just down you really quickly, so it's a huge pain in the butt. So do it solo. I had no issues when I equipped my Vectis. I had some issues when I equipped my Gricata Prime, because it does not do high damage in low bullets. Oh well, it is what it is. From there though, that's essentially the whole fight, and then you should be good to go. It might take a bit, but hey, you know what you signed up for. It's a Warframe, they take some time to farm. It is what it is, and hell, it's okay. Now, let's go over where to farm Mesa Prime. Mesa Prime is also a very simple build. The only annoying part in the build is that it requires Argon Crystals, so hey, have at it. Let's start, as usual, going over where to farm the Blueprints. Those can be grabbed in Lith D1. Meso R2, Neo Z2, and Neo Z3, with Lith D1 and Meso R2 being uncommon unvaulted, so you can actually farm those right now, but the other two are vaulted. Oh well. If we go to Lith D1, we can see that It's pretty easy to farm it at the Profit Taker Bounty Phase 2, but hey, that's whatever. More importantly, you have Disruption, Mars Olympus AB rotation, and Spy Tier 1 B drop rotations. So that's just, all in all, a very simple item to grind. And then, you know, Excavation, Survival Tier 1, Defection Tier 1, Dark Sector Tier 1. It's all very simple. Very high drop chance there. High chance you'll just play the game and get it. It's a Lith item. There's no shock there. Now, let's go over where to get the Neuroptics. Those can be picked up in Lith M4 and Lith M3. Both are rare, but Lith M3 is the only one unvaulted right now. Going over where we can farm Lith M3, that one's also pretty simple. All Tier 1 BC drops, Disruption on Mars, Spy Tier 1. Yeah, no, it's very simple. 12.5% drop chance on all those Void Tier 1A, Exterminate, Capture, along with Survival in the Derelict and Defense in the Derelict. Hey, maybe you should go farm up in the Derelict just for these. Next up, we have the Chassis. And that could be farmed in Meso C4, Neo A3, Neo C1, Axie H4, and Axie M1. We'll go over the drop pool for Meso C4, as Meso C4 and Neo A3 are the only ones that are unvaulted. That being said, this is a common drop, so it should not be too hard to farm. As we can see here, it has high drop chances from Tier 2s, some Tier 1s, exist out there, but mainly you have Disruption A in Sedna and Uranus, and a C-drop rotation on Disruptions on Mars. I would say do the Disruption on Mars, just because of how the drop tables work for Disruptions. Or you could farm A-drop rotations solo pretty easily as well. It's really up to you. Last but not least is the Systems. And that can be farmed in simply one location, Neo M2, and that is a rare drop. Wow, that's actually very surprising, but I guess it is one of the newer primes, so can't have that many relics yet. Neo M2 is actually also pretty easy farm. You have Interception Tier 2s on a BC rotation, and those are pretty simple. You have Disruption on Sedna, Lua and Uranus, as well as Survival Dark Sector 4, Survival Derelict, and Survival Void Tier 4. It's an 11% AB drop rotation there. So all of these drops for all of these are very easy because they are not Axie relics. Axie relics are essentially the only relics that are kind of hard to farm in the game because they require you to put a lot of time into survival or any other endless missions and do just generally higher, longer content. But it's not too hard in general. So guys, if you like the video, subscribe, comment, rate, favorite, and check out some of my other Warframe Hunter videos in the playlist that I'll link at the end of the video. Again, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.